1 Timothy 4:12. Do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, in purity.
The Lord said to Noah, there's gonna be a floody, floody. Lord said to Noah, there's gonna be a floody, floody. Get those children out of the muddy, muddy, children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine. Children of the Lord. So Noah, he built him an ark, arky. Noah, he built him an ark, arky. Made it strong with cedar, barky, barky. Children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Children of the Lord. The animals, they came in by twosies, twosies. Animals, they came in by twosies, twosies. I love them, and kangaroosies, twosies. Children of the Lord. So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Children of the Lord. Children of the Lord.
Hey friends, welcome to Moments with Mrs Hollee. I am super excited that you hopped on here tonight and we get to spend a little bit of time together. So I know that we can't see each other and it's been a while since we've actually got to see each other in person, but I want to tell you that no matter what, even when we're not meeting together, that God is still doing really big things. And I have a feeling that God is doing big things in your life. And I cannot wait until we get to meet again and I can hear all the things that God has been doing over the past several months in your lives. I always enjoy spending time with you, and I know I can't see you, but I do love the fact that you hop on here, and I love the fact that we get to hear a little bit from God's word, and we get to worship together. And that brings me to this. Don't forget to bring your Bibles, so later on, we can get into a little bit of a Bible lesson tonight. Of course, we have our special guests tonight, Mr. Luke and Clef, and I can't wait to see what tonight is going to be about. So are you guys ready? I can't hear you. Are you ready? You're ready. Let's go.
Speak to one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs.
All right, now that we know the names of the shapes, we have to remember that every shape represents
an animal.
No. Every shape represents a sound. That's right. You guys remember that? Every shape represents a sound. And our shapes, the sounds that they have, are actually organized in something we call a scale. And this scale was actually invented by a guy named Guido.
Oh, I know Guido. That guy makes a mean pizza.
No, not that Guido, Clef. He was in the 13th century, and he created the musical scale so that he could teach kids how to sing and worship. Isn't that cool?
That's awesome.
Okay, so what we're going to do, I'm going to need your help. We're going to sing through the scale so we can know the sound of each shape. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Good job, Clef. Good job, guys. That's the musical scale. So those notes are in the same order every single time, and that's how they sound. So every time you see the shape do, you know it sounds like do.
Like pizza.
Like pizza, that's right.
Speak to one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs.
Okay, so we've learned that every shape represents
an animal.
No, not an animal, Clef. Every shape represents a
sound.
Great, good job. So every shape represents a sound. And so for each shape, we know the sound. So every shape represents a sound. But one of the cool things we can do with shape notes is we have this thing called the movable do.
Oh, I know all about movable do. Guido moves do at the pizza place like this. He spins it around, and he throws it on the table. He pats it.
Oh,
Clef. He makes a pizza.
Oh, Clef. Well, that may be movable do in Chicago, but that's not the kind of movable do we're talking about. We're talking about we can move the sound of do so it changes the scale. You guys know Jesus Loves Me, right?
Yeah!
So here's Jesus Loves Me like we normally sing it. Do, mi, so. Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Now, what happens when we move the do? Let's see. Do, mi, so. Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. See what I did there is I moved the do. We had movable do, Clef. And when we moved the do, the shapes were the same, but it sounded different. Every shape represents a...
a sound?
You got it, Clef. Every shape represents a sound.
Speak to one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs.
All right, Clef. Next, let's talk about intervals.
Ugh, I don't like vegetables.
No, not vegetables, Clef. Intervals are the space between notes. We know that every shape represents a sound, and the shapes are in a scale that have a divine sound. So we talk about the intervals, the space between, that helps us know what notes to sing. An important interval to learn when we're talking about singing music is the do, mi, so interval. Would you guys like to sing along with me? You want to sing with me, Clef?
Yeah! Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, let's do it. Here we go. Let's follow the shapes. Do, mi, so, mi, do. Let's do that again. Do, mi, so, mi, do.
Speak to one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs.
So we've been talking about the scale and the shape notes and intervals and how they all fit together. But ultimately, what we want you to do is we want you to sing because God wants to hear your
voice.
That's right. God wants to hear your voice.
Even like a puppet's voice too?
Yes, even like a puppet's voice, Clef. He wants to hear your voice when you're young. He wants to hear your voice when you're old, your whole life. He wants you to sing to him. And just like in the body of Christ, we all have different things we do when we serve God. And when we sing, we can sing different parts.
Like parts of the pizza? I mean, you got like the crust, the cheese, pepperoni.
Oh, Clef. It's not parts like that.
Oh.
It's parts of the way we sing. So let's look at this graphic here. So we have these top set of lines. There's a top set of note. That part is the soprano part. Most of the time, that's sung by ladies who sing high. Okay, on these top set of lines, we have this bottom set of note. That is the alto part. Most of the time, that is sung by ladies who sing low. On the bottom set of lines, we have this top set of note. That's the tenor part. Most of the time, that's sung by men that sing high. And then on the bottom set of lines, we have the bottom set of notes. That is the bass part, and that is sung by men that sing very low. But you know what? It doesn't really matter what part you sing. And if you don't know what part to sing, sing along with the soprano. That's the melody. That's the part that you recognize from the radio or you recognize from Jesus Loves Me. The most important thing when you have an opportunity to sing is that everybody sing because God wants to hear your voice.
Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul.
Thank you, Lord, for inviting me.
Jesus for saving my soul.
Thank you, Lord, for inviting.
You're preparing my heavenly goal.
Hardly wait, so excited.
Now I'm part of the family.
This is something to live for.
You're providing my liberty.
Making me want to give more.
Thank you, Jesus, you opened my eyes.
Showing truth from the fiction.
Help me better to realize.
There is no contradiction.
You are God, you became a man. Now the gospel I understand.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
You are God. You became a man. Now this gospel I understand. And you've done everything you can. Now this gospel I understand.
Tú me diste la salvación. Solo en ti encuentro valor.
Serving you is a pleasure.
Hay un canto en mi corazón.
All the world's gonna hear.
Hombre, eres Dios de la creación.
Fill me now with your spirit.
Thank you, Jesus, for taking me home.
You're the one who is knowing.
The day will be so I'm never alone.
Everywhere that we're going.
Guiding me down the narrow road.
Showing me the direction.
Taking over my heavy load.
Resurrection.
You are God.
You became a man.
Now this gospel I understand.
And you've done everything you can. Now this gospel I understand. You are God. You became a man. Now this gospel I understand.
Salvaste a mi país.
And you've done everything you can. Now this gospel I understand. Thank you, Jesus, you opened my eyes. Help me better to realize.
Ay, tú dejaste todo por mí.
Para amar y sanarnos.
Tu evangelio es para mí.
Solo de Jesús la sangre.
You are God.
You are God.
Thank you, Mr. Luke and Clef, for sharing with us once again tonight. So, you know, when I was growing up, I didn't have someone like Mr. Luke that was able to share how to learn to read music, and how important is it that we learn to use our voices to praise and worship God, and not just through singing, but through prayer and how we speak. And so it's so important that we take time to go over this. And we are so blessed to have someone like Mr. Luke that not only loves music, but he loves you, and he has such a passion to teach you how to use your voice for God. And we are so blessed and grateful that he does that for us. And we look forward to next week's lesson. So Sunday, if you're paying attention to the sermon, Mr. Jerry talked to us about our reflection in the mirror. Man, my mirror was super dirty. I hope yours isn't dirty like that. And what does your reflection look like in the mirror? And I'm not talking about just like if you look in it, yes, I have glasses and I have brown eyes and right now I have on a hat. But what is your true reflection in the mirror? And I think a lot of times we forget that our reflection is basically what is in your heart. And that's what God sees. God doesn't really notice the outward appearance. I mean, although he gave us everything, he gave me my brown eyes and he gave me my color of hair and my teeth and my ears, but he is more concerned with our heart and what is in our hearts. And sometimes we forget that we are God's reflection to other people. And it's important that we always, always remember this when we are talking with anyone, and especially think about like when you go to school and the things that we say to people. Just being kind to someone is a reflection of God, and He wants us to look like Him. Well, in order to look like God, what do we have to do in order to know what that reflection is? Well, we've got to study God's word, and we have to know what's in here so we know what God expects from us. And something that I want to read to you right now is Ephesians chapter 4, and we're going to just start in verse 1, and we're going to go through verse 7. And it says, "I therefore, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one spirit, just as you were called to one hope that belongs to your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God, one Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. But grace was given to each one of us according to the measure of Christ's gift." So I encourage you to go back and read this together as a family and really understand what it's talking about. But the unity of Christ, how we show our love to one another, there's one God, there's one baptism, there's one church, and He wants us to be a reflection of that. And so, guys, my challenge to you this week is to reflect God in Jesus in everything you do. Remember our heart, love, and be patient even when it's hard, because it's going to be hard sometimes. Okay, I've had fun with you guys tonight. I cannot wait to see you next week and Sunday morning at 9:15 on our Facebook Kids, Comanche Trail Kids Facebook page live. Bye.